Hi everyone! In today's video, I will show you all the different types of dry legumes I use in my kitchen. I will show you the various techniques for soaking, cooking, and sprouting legumes, and I will also share with you the recipes I frequently make with them. Let's start with the different types of legumes I have in my pantry. First up are beans. Here I have adzuki beans, black-eyed peas, black turtle beans, cranberry beans, fava beans, great northern beans, kidney beans, lima beans, these are baby lima beans, mung beans, navy beans, and pinto beans. Next up are lentils, which come in two different forms, whole and split. Here I have beluga lentils, black lentils, brown lentils, and green lentils, all of which are whole lentils. And here are split lentils, specifically black lentils, ivory lentils, red lentils, and yellow lentils. Finally, chickpeas and peas. Just like lentils, chickpeas and peas are either whole or split. Here I have whole chickpeas, green peas, and yellow peas, and here are their split counterparts. Alright, so how do you cook all these legumes? Unless you're using split lentils, I would recommend soaking all legumes in cold water overnight. Soaking shortens cooking time, improves digestion, deactivates anti-nutrients, and increases the nutritional content of protein, fiber, and a few nutrients. I write about this in detail on my blog, so I will leave a link to the article in the description box below. Typically, I soak my legumes in cold water overnight. However, if you're short on time, you can do a quick soak in hot water for about an hour. Make sure you have a large bowl and a lot of water because legumes double, some even triple, in size after soaking. Once soaked, drain the soaking water, rinse the legumes under cold running water, and add them to a pot. You can cook legumes in just plain water, but depending on the recipe, I often add aromatics, vegetables, herbs, and spices, especially when it comes to soups and stews for which I use the bean cooking liquid. So for instance, if I am making minestrone soup, I will cook the beans with aromatics, carrots, celery, a bay leaf, and a few peppercorns. If I am making paella, I will use saffron, which adds not only flavor, but also color. As far as salt goes, I do add it either right away or once the water starts boiling, because there's no actual evidence that adding salt negatively affects cooking time. Other than cooking, you can also sprout legumes. If you have never sprouted legumes, it's actually really easy. First, soak the legumes in cold water for 8 to 12 hours. Once soaked, drain the soaking water and rinse the legumes under cold running water. You can use a sprouting jar, a DIY mason jar, or just leave the legumes in a strainer placed over a bowl. Rinse and drain the legumes 2 to 3 times a day, and in a few days, your sprouts should be ready. I have a sprouting chart on my blog, not just with legumes, but also with grains, nuts, seeds, and vegetables, if you're interested in learning more. Now onto the recipes, which you will be able to find either on my blog or in my cookbook with dinner recipes. Let's start with the classics, such as bean chili with black beans, kidney beans, and pinto beans. Grillable veggie burgers made with black beans. Chana masala with chickpeas. Dal with yellow lentils. Eggplant stew with chickpeas. Lentil walnut loaf and shepherd's pie with brown lentils or green lentils. Paella with chickpeas, and also falafel made either with soaked or sprouted chickpeas. I can't forget hummus, which you can use as a dip, mix it with pasta, use it in Buddha bowls, the applications are endless. Minestrone soup with great northern beans, or red lentil soup. And then there are less popular recipes, such as crackers. You can use any legume you like, these crackers are made from chickpeas. And finally, crepes or savory pancakes made from yellow lentils. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video, learned something new, and got some ideas on how to use dry legumes.